Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Ernst Grunfeld and Richard Ratti. This amazing chess game was played in 1922. Ernst Grunfeld was a German champion. He was famous for inventing his own opening and beating great players with it. Grunfeld introduced his defense to the world by defeating Alexander Alekhine with it in 1922. Okay, let's look at this game. The legend Ernst Grunfeld had white pieces and he started with d4. Richard Ratti played knight to f6, c4, d6, knight to f3, bishop to f5, knight to c3, h6, g3, c6. What is this funny opening called? It's called the old Indian defense. Bishop to g2, queen to c8, intending bishop to h3, and exchanging light squared bishops. h3, knight from b to d7, knight to d2, intending e4. e5, d5, bishop to e7, e4, bishop to h7, queen to e2. White has a space advantage. Ratti castled kingside. White to move. Grunfeld played knight to f1, intending knight to e3, with even stronger grip on the center. C takes on d5, c takes on d5, but now knight to c5, preventing knight to e3. g4. Well, if knight goes to e3, what happens then? Then knight from f takes on e4, and after knight takes knight, bishop takes on e4. If knight goes to d2, defending the pawn on e4, this would be an admission that the plan, the intended plan, was wrong. So, Grunfeld continued with g4, intending knight to g3 and knight to f5. Indeed, if white knight gets to f5, it would look very impressive. Black to move. What is the best way to counter white's idea of knight to g3 and knight to f5? What would you do? Ratti attacked on the other wing with b5, even offering the pawn for free. But the pawn is not really free. Knight to g3 was played. If knight takes on b5, then white loses the center pawn. So we have knight to g3, b4, knight to d1, black to move. I suppose this must have been a very important moment of the game, because Ratti was involved in some deep thinking. What was he thinking about? My opinion is that he was thinking about his next move. Just kidding. No, I'm not. I'm serious. Please pause and find the best move for black. You don't need to pause for too long. Pause for a minute, or maybe only 60 seconds. But pause. What did you find? If you pause and find the move, you will get more pleasure out of watching this video. If you don't believe me, just read the text on the side of the video. Are you ready to see the move? Ratti played. Knight takes on d5. Wow. What is this? Is this a correct sacrifice? The best way to find out if it's correct is to accept it. E takes on d5. Black to move. What was the idea behind the sacrifice? Winning lots of pawns is definitely not the idea. You look for checks, captures. There is knight to d3. Very important check. King to d2. Of course, Grunfeld considered king to f1. And then like knight takes bishop on c1. Black gets his piece back. So, Grunfeld played king to d2, knight to f4, attacking the queen. This is definitely a monster knight, which is terrorizing the whole white camp. Queen to f3. Queen to c2. Shach. Black. Light squared bishop is doing very important job, isn't he? King to e1. Knight to d3, check. The monster knight moved again. King to f1. Knight takes bishop on c1. Knight to f5. Blocking the bishop on h7 and attacking the bishop on e7. Bishop to g5. White's position is so difficult to play that after a long thinking, Grunfeld decided to kill the monster knight by paying a heavy price for it. Heavy piece was used to capture the monster knight. Bishop takes on c1. Knight from d to e3. Bishop takes on e3. F takes on e3. Well, queen takes on e3 is no better. Bishop takes on f5, and after g takes on f5, queen takes on b2. So we have f takes on e3. Bishop takes knight on f5. Pawn takes bishop. Black played the move and white resigned. And the move is queen takes pawn on b2. Grunfeld resigned. Why? Well, he was afraid that he might lose another pawn. Just kidding. For the entertainment purpose, I will show you just one line. Queen to g4, intending f6, and then queen takes on g7, checkmate. Rook from a to c8. King to g1. F6 doesn't work because of rook to c1, check. So we have king to g1, rook to c1, check. King to h2. Rook takes rook, check. King takes rook. Queen to c1, check. King to h2. Queen takes pawn on e3. And black is easily winning. F6, which was the only hope, doesn't work because of queen to f4, check. And after queen takes queen, pawn takes queen, and black rook would eat white bishop for a breakfast. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.